Question today, will Congress demand a change to the relationship with Pakistan because of the fact that he was hiding in plain sight? You can share your thoughts with me on Twitter, on Facebook. My email is contessa@msnbc.com. Senator Jim Risch is a Republican from Idaho. He sits on several committees, including intelligence and foreign relations. Senator, good to see you today.
Good to see you. That was an excellent question you asked about Congress's demands for reviewing the relationship with Pakistan.
Well, and do you think we need to rethink our partnership with Pakistan?
Well, we rethink it constantly. As you know, the situation that you've described as regarding the recent incident, we already went through one time, or more than one time, actually, as we've used the Predator and drone strikes in Pakistan. And the government will say one thing one day, the government of Pakistan will say one thing one day, and another thing another day. And our relationship is complex, it's difficult, but we have to deal with Pakistan for a lot of different reasons, which I think are quite obvious.
And what about the financial relationship, the fact that we've been sending them roughly $1 billion a year since 2001? Is the financial relationship something that is going to get close scrutiny at this point?
Well, again, it has been over the years. It's getting scrutiny every day, and I know there's some senators have already called for cutting that off. I'm sure we're going to have a discussion about that. We clearly want accountability. After all, they are a nuclear nation, and a lot of people up here were questioning putting the money into it, wondering whether it was going into the nuclear program. Obviously, there's another country in the world that is more interested in than the United States as to where that money is going and whether it's going into the nuclear program.
Senator, given the fact that we went into Afghanistan with the intention of annihilating the terrorists who attacked our country and annihilating those who would harbor them. We have Osama bin Laden now. Is there a point to us remaining in Afghanistan to keep fighting the insurgency there?
Well, as you pointed out, we went in there originally to drive out al-Qaeda. We have been tremendously successful in driving out al-Qaeda. Unfortunately, they went just across the border into Pakistan. Many have fled to Yemen, many have fled to Somalia. So the developments are going to continue to follow them. What's happening in Afghanistan is constantly evaluated here. I'm on the Foreign Relations Committee. We had a lengthy hearing yesterday getting the views of various people as to what the path forward is there. That's going to be reevaluated in the future, I have no doubt. This will clearly play a role in it. How big a role it plays, a lot of it's going to depend upon everyone's individual view as to how what the significance was of eliminating bin Laden, which obviously has considerable significance.
And given your role on the Intelligence Committee, there are three provisions of the Patriot Act which expire at the end of this month. One authorizes the FBI to continue to use roving wiretaps on surveillance targets. Another allows the government to seize any tangible items in the course of surveillance, and the third one is this lone wolf provision that allows surveillance of targets not connected to known terror groups. And again, those allowances are scheduled to expire. The Attorney General has said he wants them to be reauthorized. What's your prediction? Will they be?
My prediction is they will be reauthorized. We have been tremendously successful as far as avoiding another attack since September 11th on homeland soil. And you've got to give great credit to our intelligence agencies. They need the tools to do that. And by the way, obviously, we've all discussed what the fallout could be as far as retaliation from what just happened. And one of the big issues is the lone wolf provision. That is someone who's acting totally on their own, someone who is not receiving direction from any other command and control structure of al-Qaeda. The lone wolf provision is an important provision.
Senator, it's good to see you today. Thank you so much for sharing a few minutes with us. A bit of history made Sunday night, apart from the killing of Osama bin Laden. Nine networks across the United States broadcast the president